I was going on the whack bag and reading some of the message board, and Jimmy posted a thank you to the listeners and stuff, saying that it was very cool for them to show up and how cool they were, and you know they were there from the start of this whole thing. And I copy and pasted it and just wrote yuck underneath, like, Jimmy's whole thing, thanking the listeners. Because, like, there's a whole bunch of posts of, dude, you know, we're here for you, and a lot of the listeners, like, yeah, thanking you. I just posted what Jimmy wrote and then wrote, yuck, under it. And I got hammered, man. Dude, give the guy his moment. Like, they saw no humor in it whatsoever. And I was going to respond, like, I'm only kidding. And I'm like, no, screw this. Why? It's so funny. Like, I would ever go, ugh, to like Jimmy being sincere and be serious about it. Dude, give him his moment, man.
We rarely get serious on the show. And when we do, we just get smashed for it. It's the best.
Jimmy was being totally sincere.
I thanked Whackbag and Cringe. I'm like, you know, whatever, you guys, sorry so much. And then I got shit from OpieandAnthony.net.
I'm like,
well, dude, we all showed up, too. I'm like, and like, one guy was a real sarcastic prick in an IM. I guess OpieAnthony.net doesn't merit a thank you, do we?
Oh,
like, right. So, my apologies. I went over there and posted. I was just not intentional slight.
All these message boards are trying to compete with each other.
Yeah,
and they're trying to get us involved. And
yeah.
No.
It's really funny.
They all serve a purpose.
Yeah.
They really all serve a purpose. They're trying to do a divide and conquer. They write me, you know, emails on the side. Do you understand what they do over there, and we don't do that over here? It's like we're supposed to all be on the same team.
Yep.
As long as they are, quote, fan sites, I don't, you know, we don't care.
It.
At times you read some of these sites and you realize they're not really fan sites.
There it
but
is. Like, yuck.
Oh, there it is. All right, go down. Go down. Let me see what the next guy wrote. Come on, Ant. Let him have his moment.
Let him have his moment.
Oh, is there a problem between you two? Is this, what's
what?
Going on? You and,
yeah.
You
and Jim? Me and Jimmy.
You and Jimmy? Something you want to get off your chest?
No.
You sure?
Not on the air, man. Not on the air. Get off the air.
I probably deserve a drippy sap I am. The funniest thing, like, I stop at my blogs, I got bored. And plus, I'm creatively here. There's nothing better than
right.
Talking all day.
Well, when we were off the air, you had the blog going. It was hysterical.
But
it
saps you being in studio,
yeah.
You know, because mm-hmm. You're talking. But the last time I went on a post, it was after Carson died. And I posted something sincere, and did I get my face smacked. I wanted to laugh, and I waited for this drippy shit. Oh, they really gave me a beating.
You still have that up there?
I don't know.
Come on, you have it.
It probably is. I haven't gone to the blog since then.
Can we read it on the air?
Yeah, I don't think it's nothing funny about it.
Good one.
No,
kissing
I know,
his dead ass, Jimmy.
Oh, yeah, it was stuff like
it's
that.
It's not going to get you on the Tonight Show.
The next time I want to read about someone's dead ass being kissed, oh, they gave me a beating.
Really?
Which was funny.
It was. Really was.
Oh, they smashed my fat face.
Let's go to Spencer in Michigan. Spencer.
Spencer.
Hey, back to finding stuff in your parents' drawers. I was going through when I was 13, and I looked through, and I found a slip of paper, kind of instructions of what you're supposed to do after an abortion in my mom's drawer.
Wow.
Oh, you could have had another sibling there, bro.
Oh, I can't look at my mom the same anymore. Ugh.
It'd be funny if they had the information with your picture paperclip to it, like as a reminder as a reminder of what happens when these procedures aren't followed.
All right, let's go to Bubba in Oklahoma. Bubba.
Yes, sir.
What's up, Bubba?
Hey, what's going on, boys?
Hey.
You tell us, bro.
No, you talking about your mom and shit. I got married. My mom and dad are divorced. I brought my new wife home to meet my mother. Walked in the house, and her new boyfriend are in the kitchen, butt naked. She's on his knee, sucking his dick.
Stop it.
I'm dead fucking serious. Ugh. That's a hell of a way to introduce your new wife.
It certainly is.
Did she have good technique?
I didn't stay and watch that long. I was just ill.
Oh, all right. All right, thanks, bro.
Yeah, later.
Bye.
I don't believe that.
Yes.
You really don't believe that much?
No, malarkey. Bunch of malarkey.
Do we want to read this?
Is that it? That quick?
Goodbye.
Oh, my God. Ah, I don't have to read it on the air. It's too long.
This
is embarrassing.
This is Goodbye, Johnny.
Faggot I am.
I woke up this afternoon.
Aw. Yuck.
To learn what the rest of the country already knew. Johnny Carson had died. I'm greatly saddened by his death. All right, Lincoln.
I stink.
I'm greatly saddened by his death. He was one of my true idols from childhood. I am not necessarily sad that he died. He was 79. Ruled the late-night television for 30 years and is as much a part of...
You didn't write Americana and put it in quotation marks. You did not write Americana as baseball or rock and roll.
Wow.
I'm glad this is long. Yuck.
Why? We got time.
Now we got a break, dude.
No, we really
have for an hour. People,
the truth, we really don't have to.
I got a pinkle. Commercials. We're getting calls already.
I can remember being 12 or 13 and my mother knocking on my bedroom door telling me to get to sleep as I stood in front of my black and white television jerking off to Johnny Carson. No, of course not. With a tape recorder taping comedians on The Tonight Show. Well, that's kind of cool. Nothing real. The first character.
Dude, believe
rough,
me.
Jimmy.
As you're reading it, I want to take my own hand and mush my fat face into the console. Yeah. Americana.
Well, right after the Americana line is pretty interesting.
Like Rockwell? Yeah.
If given the opportunity, I'd happily ditch my career in life and trade it for his.
Oh. You'd rather be dead?
Sometimes, Ant.
All right, well. All right, I see cock blocked. That's nice. You got a little blue.
Should we get... All right, go through this. Get the good stuff for after the break.
Come back and be one line across something at the end.
Ugh. I know. I'm trying to look for some other maudlin piece of crap like Americana.
I should be fucking beaten for that. I really am.
Part of Americana.
But not now on my blog. All I'm doing is posting Rockwell paintings. Fucking jizz bucket. Ugh, melodramatic sap.
All right. Well, oh, I like the last sentence. That's
dude,
a good one.
I should be just kicked.
Mm-hmm. He was a large part of my youth, and his death just reinforces that I am indeed getting older, and the days of childhood hero worship are gone forever. I loved Johnny Carson for making me laugh, and I loved him for what he taught me. I only wish I could have let him know it.
That's terrific. That's terrific. Boy, I really have to post something after that, some type of a hooker story or something awful.
It's actually not as bad as I thought.
Thanks.
It's fine. It's
yeah.
fine.
Drip.
It's fine.
Drip. Maybe I should. You know, I should have done. I should have wrote a poem about Johnny and what he meant to me. You were a millionaire, and I'm not. Fuck you, corpse.
Here's one of the responses to Jimmy's blog post. We could Scrotum 3.
We could play Empty Garden for you in memory of Johnny Carson if you like. You got that song for Jimmy today?
Scrotum 3. I waited over a month for this blubbering sob fest. Your life's about as exciting as my paraplegic cousin who needs a mechanism to breathe. Blubbering sob.
That was the, I remember reading that one. As the New
York sunset, yeah. I found an empty garden. I guess the thing that bothers me most about his death is that I'm finally being forced to recognize that he is not coming back. You wrote that. I've known it all along, and yet. There was always that little part of me that hoped he would make a triumphant return and things would be just like they were before. I missed the sense of wonder I got from watching him. The sense of awe. No one on television does that for me anymore, and I doubt anyone ever will again. And watched it fall. Ugh. He was a funny human being, as there ever was. Self-deprecating, impeccable timing, and an absolutely razor-sharp wit. Only when watching 100 other talk show hosts can you really appreciate the greatness of Carson. That's true. The people are going here for a good... So I was fucking her in the ass! And they get that. Actually makes a lot of sense. A couple of little... What was the word?
Let's hear the
blubbering
hook.
Sob fest. Blubbering sob fest.
God damn it, are you fucking with me?
You can act like a man. Can't you come
out to play? It's over, Johnny.
Scott G. Hey, little Jimmy, you don't post for weeks and weeks, and then a week post. Sob, sob, boo-hoo.
Okay, terrific.
You're just sad because now you can't get a picture with Johnny, celebrity whore. Just a good-natured ribbing. You know I love you. Yeah, he came back. Mike said, this just in, Dear Abby is doing dick jokes. And Sticky White Discharge says, you suck. It's about time you posted something new here. Get your flabby white tits on here more and remove your nose from Johnny's rotting ass.
Or I will unscrew your head and chip down your neck.
They didn't appreciate the
as they should
post.
As they shouldn't have. There are other ones I would have preferred.
And I know that song was for John Lennon. Let's relax.
Oh,
it worked.